Hey you guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new here. My name is Ruby, and before jumping any further into today's video, be sure to click that subscribe button. We are trying to reach 5K, hopefully by the end of this year. That is the next goal for this channel, so be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. I post new videos 3 times a week, so there's always new content to binge. Today's video is one that I am so very excited for. I mentioned possibly wanting to film a review of this item in my last Amazon favorites video, and I got a ton of requests to do so, so I figured, you know what, you guys obviously want to see it. And so today I'm gonna be giving you guys my thoughts and review on the Amazon Kindle Oasis. This is the 2020 edition, so it is like the brand new version. Now, if you guys don't know, this is Amazon's newest and kind of most high-tech e-reader, and I had been on the market for an e-reader for a really long time because, if you guys don't know, I am obsessed with reading. I love to read. And so I finally bit the bullet and bought this little guy. There's a little ad on the front right now. And I feel like you guys probably already know this, considering that I've mentioned this in an Amazon favorites video, but this has quickly become one of my favorite products, one of my favorite things that I bought all of 2020. And so I just wanted to kind of make a whole dedicated video about this. Black Friday is coming up, the holidays are coming up. Some of you guys I know have winter birthdays. So if you've been looking at this, eyeing this, this video is probably for you. So the Kindle Oasis originally retails for $249.99. However, I bought mine on Amazon Prime Day back in October, and I believe I got it for somewhere around $180. Rumor has it that the Kindle Oasis is going to be dropping down to that same price for Black Friday. So if you've been eyeing it, I feel like that's kind of the best price you're gonna get for this. And to be honest, I think the price is totally worth it, even though it is definitely more expensive than some of the more basic Kindles, but we'll get into that a little later. I'm going to have the link for this in the down bar below, the same exact one that I have. So I have the graphite color, and then I just got the really basic kind of like charcoal gray case for it. For the rest of this video though, I am gonna take this Kindle out of the case just so that you guys can see the full device. Okay, so out of the case, here is what the Kindle Oasis looks like. So it has this really interesting design where half of it is kind of almost a little bit more raised. That's just so that it's easier to hold in your hand, which, let me just say, wow, what a difference it makes. I used to have one of like the OG Kindles, and honestly, like, it was just so bulky, it was so slow, I didn't love it. And so having one of like the brand new versions, it's like night and day. Now, some people might say, you know, in this day and age, what's the benefit of like getting an e-reader? You know, if I have an iPad, I can just download books to that, or, you know, I could just buy an iPad and also have a piece of tech equipment that I can use for like so many different things. But for me, what I love about this is the fact that it's so simple. Literally all I can do on this device is read, which I love because I really think that it frees me up from any other distractions. I work for myself, I work off of my computer and my iPhone, and so I feel like if I was to download like a book onto my iPhone, or if I was to buy myself an iPad, I would just get way too distracted and end up like answering emails or scrolling through social media. And so by having this one device that literally all it does is read books, all I can do is download a book, it really just helps me like keep up with my reading at the end of every single day. And I feel like, again, it just frees me from distractions. So up next, I want to talk about the screen, because one of the things that really kind of like concerns me when it comes to e-readers is the screen size. As you guys can tell, I have glasses. My eyes are pretty bad. And so one of the reasons that I've always hesitated to purchase an e-reader is because I need a larger screen, which is why I didn't want to get one of the original Kindles. It was just a little too small for me, and I could just kind of feel the eye strain coming on. But I feel like for the first time, this is actually a screen size that I can get behind. And you can obviously like adjust the font size and everything, but I typically just go with like the standard font size because this screen size is truly perfect. I love the fact that it's anti-glare. It's really, really easy on the eyes. I can read in like bright direct sunlight, and like I said, I'm not gonna really get a glare on this, which is great. The Kindle Oasis also has adjustable warm and cooler light, which is great. So depending on like the time of day you're reading, it can automatically adjust for you. I've taken this to do some reading in Central Park. I've read late at night, and I just love the fact that it has so many different settings when it comes to the lighting. Even though this is a piece of tech equipment, I've never experienced eye strain with this. In fact, I feel like it's incredibly gentle on the eyes. And you can also kind of like invert the settings. I'll show you guys what I mean. So like when you're reading a book, you know, typically it's white pages, black font, but at night, if it's easier on the eyes to kind of make it a black page and white font, you can do that as well. Personally, personally, I just like usually stick to this and I just adjust the lighting to make it a little bit more warm or cool. This might seem like a feature that doesn't really matter in the long run, but this is truly what kind of pushed me over the edge, and that is the fact that the Kindle Oasis has buttons to turn the pages. You guys have probably seen on most e-readers, not just Kindles, you have to like swipe to turn the page, and for some reason, I feel like that's just like too much. I love the fact that you have these two buttons here, so I can literally hold this in one hand and just like continuously turn the pages as I'm reading. Now, I'm a righty, but you can also actually adjust it if you're a lefty and the Kindle will automatically rotate for you. I know it sounds so funny though, but truly, like if this device didn't have the page turning buttons, I might have thought about it for a little bit longer, but because it had that feature, I was like, okay, I'm sold. I feel like so many more brands should like do the same thing. Also, you guys, I'm really sorry about the sun. I don't know like what's happening. We're getting some crazy lighting here today and it's all landing directly on my forehead, but we're just gonna keep going. I wish you guys could reach the camera and feel how ridiculously lightweight this is. Like every single friend or family member that I have shown my Kindle Oasis to, they're like, oh my God, it is so light. Like this weighs nothing. And even when I put the case on it, it barely adds any weight to it. I actually really like when the case is on it because it kind of feels like I'm reading a book. There are times where I'll literally like hold the case like this so it kind of feels like I'm reading a book, or I will just obviously kind of do it so that I can hold it in one hand. One of the things that I remember about the original Kindle that I had is how slow it was. To get to the Amazon store on my Kindle to buy a book would take forever, to download the book would take forever, even if my Wi-Fi was great, and then like turning the pages, I feel like it would always take like 5 seconds to refresh. Everything on this device is so incredibly fast though, and I mean, I would expect that considering this is the most expensive e-reader that Amazon has. So I would expect them to kind of like pull out all the bells and whistles for this, but truthfully, like so fast. Takes half a second to turn the page. Getting to the Amazon store, super fast. Downloading a book literally takes like 30 seconds. I also have Kindle Unlimited on my Kindle Oasis just because I'm a big reader and I felt like $9.99 a month for a pretty like extensive library was worth it. And so anytime like I need to swap out a book or download more, seriously, so fast. Oh my God, it's so bright. We just put down the blinds for the rest of this video. Is this one of like the messiest tech reviews you've ever seen? This is why I don't do these videos a lot, because I'm very passionate about my Kindle. Gotta help my readers out there. Like, I'm here for you. The last thing I wanna mention is the battery life. Now, I have found the best way to make sure that the battery lasts for as long as possible is, unless you were actively downloading a book, turn your Wi-Fi off on this device. So like put it on airplane mode. Because having it on Wi-Fi continuously will definitely eat up the battery a little faster. I mean, it still lasts a ridiculously long time. However, once it is on airplane mode, this thing has lasted me over a week and a half easy. I would say I read for probably an hour, hour and a half, almost every single night. I mean, obviously there are some days where I'm just too busy to do that. So let's say, okay, let's say I read like an hour to an hour and a half, 5 days a week. This has lasted me easily over a week and a half, probably closer to 2 weeks. I think the battery on this is fantastic. If you're taking a long road trip, if you're gonna be on a super long flight, you don't have to worry about like this device dying on you halfway through your read. So finally, I guess the only thing to wrap this up with is it worth it? To me, this device absolutely is. Now, obviously, no matter if you get like the basic Kindle or the most advanced one, the Kindle Oasis, all of the Amazon e-readers kind of do the same thing, right? Like they all just read. And even though obviously like this device can't do anything like super crazy compared to the original Kindle, to me, I feel like if you're gonna go with any of the e-readers, it should be this one. The little changes that they have made in this device honestly make a big difference to me. The page turning buttons, how easy it is to hold, how light it is to hold, the adjustable light. Also, the Kindle Oasis is water resistant. So if you ever do some like poolside reading, or maybe you're out and about and it starts to rain, you're totally protected with this Kindle, where I know some of the more basic versions you're not. I don't really expect to be like dropping this in a bathtub anytime soon, but like if I am outside and it starts to drizzle, I don't have to worry about like this device getting ruined, which is really nice. I would definitely say wait until this goes on sale to get it though, obviously, because I'm not blind to the fact that this is really expensive for what it does, or I guess what little it does, because like it's not a tablet. It's literally just an e-reader. So I would definitely wait until you can get it on sale for Black Friday or for Prime Day. But I have truly so enjoyed this literally from day one. I think I've now officially had this for about a month and a half. I have taken it everywhere with me. Anytime I'm out and about, I always throw this in my bag. Truly though, like if I wasn't obsessed with this, A, I wouldn't be making a video on it, but also B, like I would have returned return this, but I just love it. And hands down, this is one of like the best purchases that I have made all of 2020. There you guys have it. That is my review on the Amazon Kindle Oasis, the 2020 version, the newest version. I hope this answered all of your questions. However, if you have any additional questions, comments, thoughts, if you have the Kindle Oasis and you love it too, leave a comment down below. I love chatting with you guys. Again, be sure to click that subscribe button. We are trying to reach 5,000, hopefully by the end of this year. That would seriously be like the best end of the year present ever. Follow me on all of my other social media networks. The links are always in the down bar below. Subscribe to my podcast. Check out my Amazon shop if you want to know what some of my other favorite products from Amazon are. The links are always down below. And until my next video, I hope you all are staying safe, happy, and healthy, and I will talk to you guys in my next one. Okay? Bye, everybody.